Hey everybody, Star Six Wars One here, and welcome to my second review that is unrelated to anything like Anime Movie Month or Full Metal Alchemist Month or anything like that. This one is of another anime I recently finished, Kanon 2006. Now, as the 2006 implies, this is actually the second anime toward it. And there was another one made in 2002. I have not seen it. I've not even heard about it. Well, I've heard about it, obviously. But I've never watched it, and I never will. I don't need to after watching this one. Anyway, I've heard it's complete crap anyways. Kanon was originally an, believe it or not, an adult visual novel. Though, I think that's not really a surprise. But this one was developed by Key. They're famous for their visual novels, Clannad being, in my opinion, their most famous and best work. But enough on the talk of that. Let's get into the story. The story follows Yuichi and his trying to get his memory back and visiting his aunt and cousin, because I think his parents are working out somewhere. I was never clear on that one. And he would meet girls of his past, or in at least one case, girl of his present, that would have their own little problems, and that needed to be fixed. And Yuichi, being the miracle worker he was, I'm being very sarcastic on that, because I'll be honest, it's a basic Key kind of plot. The same is true of Air and Clannad. The difference here is there's a lot less romance this time around. Though I won't deny that there's still romance in there. So yeah, please remember that. What I don't mind the story personally, but it's not one of my particular favorites. Then again, the same could be said of Clannad. I was never in it for the story. The characters were always it. So let's go to them. First up, Yuichi Aizawa. Can I be wrong and say he's kind of a dick? I'm sorry. He's very much one of those people that will tease. But his teasings can go very far sometimes and can seem, at times, very mean-spirited. Especially to Ayu, the main love interest of the series. And again, I personally don't think I'm giving anything away when I say that. With how heavily she's emphasized in the opening, it's really easy to tell that she's the main love interest. Though I will give Yuichi this one thing. During the drama scenes, he can be good. It's just I find him kind of an asshole and at times really unlikable. And for a main character, that's really a bad thing. Thankfully, we have the females of it to soften the blow. The previously mentioned Ayu being personally a nice contrast to Yuichi. She's very young, very energetic, and very seemingly happy-go-lucky, but the truth of the matter is there's a lot more going on to her character than meets the eye. And I'm going to be honest, she's a very interesting character, and I really do like her. Not my favorite, but I do like her. Next up, we have Yuichi's cousin, Nayuki. I don't think there's enough scenes with her in it, but judging by the fact that she's not a love interest, and thank you for that, I can see why, and I think she's actually a nice supporting character. So, there's that. Next, we go to Makoto. People are not going to like me for saying this, but I don't really like Makoto. Early on, she was a very big prankster, but could sometimes, in my opinion, go just as bad as Yuichi could. And it could get annoying at times, and I can see why Yuichi got really annoyed with Makoto a lot. True that I think her character improves over time, but for me, never completely gets better. Sorry, but that's my opinion. Next up, we go with Shiori, the favorite for pretty much everyone, and my second favorite character in the show. She is very much a very calm person, very happy, and almost like a little sister to Yuichi. If that makes any sense. Shiori is very kind, but also has a very dark past, and has a grim future. I'm not gonna spoil anything, though. Watch for yourselves to see. But I will say Shiori is one of the nicest characters in this. And last up of the characters I want to talk about, we have my personal favorite character. She is very badass in the fact she fights demons every night in the school. And there's a psychological reason for that, but that's a spoiler again. She's also best friends with another character called Sayori, who has almost just as tragic, if not even more tragic, backstories than half the cast. Mai isn't very much the emotionless girl, and she can be kind of similar to, I guess, Rei Ayanami in that regard. But what makes me like her better than Rei was that she was really, really good, and she could show emotion when it was needed. And one of my favorite scenes actually shows her emotion and having a breakdown after her friend Sayori gets hurt. Sorry for the spoilers. Overall, I do like the characters, even if there's one or two that make me want to groan. Next up, we go with the music. I'm going to be frank here and say this right now. I think Clannad had a better soundtrack, but I won't deny this one had at least a nice one. A few notable tracks were on the CD. Can't remember the names, sorry, but I do like their tracks, and this one isn't a half bad one either. So, points to that. I'm also going to just briefly mention, this is part of the moe genre, and I'll be very honest in saying this right now, I don't give a damn about it. And that's my personal opinion. I don't give a damn about moe. So that makes my watching the English dub nicer. The English dub is pretty good, with notable performances from Brittany Karbowski, who played Ayu in one of the very few roles I cannot picture her playing Pride from Fullmetal Alchemist Brotherhood. But my personal notable performance of the dub is Chris Patton as Yuichi. While I admit he's kind of an ass, Yuichi, Chris Patton plays him pretty well. And even if the kind of reminds me of Greed at times. Yeah, you get what you get. That's kind of one of the things I do sometimes. What you gonna do? Next up, I want to talk about this. This series could be funny sometimes. I have two particular scenes I really love when it comes to hilarity. Yuichi trying to trick Makoto into buying a porno mag. It's hilarious. I originally saw it in Shadow ACS's videos, and it still cracks me up months after seeing it. It is hilarious. My other one I'd like to note, though, is the dance number with Yuichi and the Sunohara clone. Yeah, there's a Sunohara in this one. I can never remember his name, so I just call him the Sunohara clone. Even sure it's the same voice actor, Greg Aries. It's so stupid looking. Pretty much if you see the girls' reaction, the three girls, Ayu, a classmate, and Ayuki's reaction to it, that's pretty much my reaction to that whole scene. And to give this show credit, it can be really emotional too. I almost cried more than once, especially in Mai's arc. Though I never actually cried. I could feel the tears in episodes 14 and 15 as I mentioned in my reaction video, but other than that, I never cried. So, sorry guys. Now I'm going to get into two problems I have with the series other than the main character. I don't think the happy and sad moments mesh well. This is a personal opinion of mine. I think that they do very well and they try very hard. But the problem is, I don't think the two mesh well. Happy moments seem like a major mood whiplash when compared to their sadder scenes. And it's none more evident when an episode ends on a sad note with one of the most cheery end tunes I've ever heard. Yeah, that's kind of jarring. And ultimately hurt my experience of the show a little bit. Also, my final full-on complaint would be everything that I think this show did good, Clannad did better. The animation, better. Story, debatable, but better, in my opinion. Music, my opinion, better. Characters. Just compare Miyuichi to Tomohya, and that's it. And I only get to the last bit, the Deus Ex Machina ending, where everything ends all happily, and that. I don't buy it. Okay, we go with a few episodes before, the aunt of Yuichi and the mother of Nayuki being hit by a car, to a very happy ending about 3 or 4 episodes later. Yeah, I'm not buying that. Not at all. Sorry, but... And I really wish to say I like the ending or I hate the ending. It's more of a I just don't know how to feel about the ending. I mean, it ends on a happy note and I prefer happy endings over sad ones, but... This one's kind of pushing it. And I don't know if I buy the ending, so... Sorry, I don't know if I like the ending. Even Clannad did that better. At least I could tell I liked the ending, even if it was Deus Ex Machina-like. Overall, I think this series is good. Do not get me wrong on this. Hell, I even think there are one or two things this does better than Clannad. The Emotionless Girl is my personal thing that I think this one did better. Overall, though, really good series. Recommend it. But just to be warned... You have to get past some of the more annoying and irritating scenes with Yuichi and the mood whiplash back and forth. I give Kanon 2006 an 8.5 out of 10. It would have ranked a little higher had it not been for some of the more irritating scenes I had to listen through. But I'm at least going to say I enjoyed it. This has been Star 6 Wars 1, and thanks for watching.